bitches catching my wind. That only happens to them. I gotta capture my wind. I practice 31 days a month and I practice again. Was born equipped with sportsmanship, so watch us laugh and I grin. Victory is my objective, I don't have to pretend. Spread my wings like an eagle and let them flap in the wind. No guns, no glory, no pain, no gain. These are actions of men. My teammate is a warrior, got my back to the end. My offense is God sent, you gon' have to defend. My crossover is vicious, I got more swagger than him. Hit the bottom of the net or the back of the rim. Your style is a flagrant foul, your score I'ma take it down. All of your trash talking was pointless, say it now. You slacking and goaltending, my actions are bone chilling. Got the home court advantage, I'm back on the road winning, road winning. I gotta hold down the city.
I gotta hold down the city.
Gotta let you know where I come from.
Gotta hold the city down. Anyhow, they gon' have to really bail. Totally dominate the game in front of
me.
A tak a propos, dawno nie widziałem się w okularach.
Do szkoły ty masz. Dobra, pokażę ci jak opłacę na szkół. Nie do końca. Już tyle?
No.
O Boże, nie?
Świeci?
Przecież kraftą cały czas mam. Bo taka cena. Znaczy to nie jest promocja cena, bo wiesz co? Wchodzimy do sklepu. Michał nam i patrzy. Ty,
ona kosztuje trochę nie wiem.
I mam teraz dwie mychy.
He. No Michał, cię zaprosiłem już.
O, jesteś.
Fajny odpływ?
Nigdzie coś.
Siamo fragili. Se tutti ci toccano. Siamo fatti di. Sogni che non ci fa.
Dobra, czekaj. Teraz grało.
Prywatne ma, czy przecież nie ma?
Mentre insieme siamo immortali, baby accelero la moto, chiudi gli occhi e spegni i fanali, vedi noi siamo la luce insieme, il male che produce il bene, la notte abbassa lo sguardo che guardarci non gli conviene, siamo il bianco e siamo il nero, siamo Dio che appare davvero, siamo piccoli e perfetti, mondo visto dal cielo.
Siamo fragili, se tutti ci toccano.
Dziwnego.
Cammino sulle mine, per te passo questo confine, portando nel bagagliaio cose che non ti posso dire. La mia vita è un film come al cine, io te polio posti al caline, solo tu mi rilassi alla fine, solo tu mi rilasci endorfine. Non mi fido delle altre bambine, siamo unici tigri albine, sotto il sole di mezzanotte io ti scriverò le mie rime. E la nostra vita è musica, quindi rapo sul tuo battito. E quando gente ci giudica, nessuno coglie quest'attimo. Sognando
per...
Czekaj, chwilę, muszę się zmienić na TS-ie tam. Bo pod przycisk mam. I teraz słyszysz mnie? Nie?
O nie.
A teraz? Halo.
Halo.
Słyszysz mnie?
Tak, weź wyjść z tego jeszcze raz, chcę, proszę.
Cerchiamo come animali, a piedi nudi come gitani, contro il mondo con le mani, come se non ci fosse un domani. Ora siamo pronti a tutto, a cose che non possiamo dire, a sogni che non fanno dormire, noi siamo l'inizio e la fine. Non devo guardare il cielo per capire da dove piove, se mi cerchi sono già altrove, indirizzo nuvola 9, io che ti ho coperta d'oro dei nostri giorni preziosi, ed ora piango sangue e gli dei sono tutti invidiosi.
Siamo fragili. Tutti ci toccano, siamo fatti di sogni che non ci fanno dormire, cose che non si possono dire, insieme siamo l'inizio e la fine.
Jaki masz ty? Pokaż. Weź kółko, B. Ja bym go, dobra.
Nie,
no tak. We're all set to bring you NBA action. This is Kevin Harlan, and here with me tonight, Greg Anthony, Clark Kellogg, and Doris Burke reporting from the sideline. And the Houston Rockets starting five. Cody Unis and Howard, the post pair. Everly and Harden, they're the backcourt. And it's a reason in the three.
Butler is one of those guys who had to overcome major odds just to get to the NBA.
Się pytał, czy gramy, a Rama nie mówi, że nie, ale mówi, że od Majka to jeszcze mógłby zagrać. A oni usłyszą, później zaczęli grać z kaczyną w bankada, to o kurwa, fajnie się ubrał.
And so here is Houston. As to Monty Unis. Now the dish to Howard.
From 10 feet out,
and Harden with the basket on the assist by Howard.
Going back to Jimmy Butler, there were just so many times when he was set up to fail.
Now in the NBA, so his freshman year at a junior college, which I think humbled him just a bit, but maybe gave him that work ethic that is so much Greg a part of his game now.
And Kevin, the talent was there, and most of all, as we see how he dealt with adversity, the heart was there. He blocked out the distractions, and finally transferred to a major college, and worked his way into becoming a first-round pick. I tell you what, he has quite the act to follow, but Fred Hoiberg was a quick choice for the Brass in Chicago. Signed that five-year deal over the summer, was easily one of the most in-demand coaches available.
This is his first free throw of the game. Well, Greg, for Hoiberg, it's his first job as an NBA head coach. Now, we know he played. He's been a part of an NBA front office.
So,
he came from Iowa State, where he honed his coaching skills and was highly respected.
Yeah, very much respected, particularly as an offensive coach. And we know the Bulls are pretty solid defensively, and he'll be looking to ramp up that offensive approach for that team, and I think he will.
Here's Monty Unis. That shot is off target. That makes him 2 for 3.
Boom.
Just floating to the rim on that slam.
Boy, when he gets up and stays
man,
up.
Man, you could clock his hang time with an hourglass.
Boom.
Throws down the breakaway jam.
Just a great job of attacking on the break.
Yeah, you know, exploding Chicago, to the Chicago basket Bulls. Like that, Greg, just as soon as that ball was going the other way, that's exactly how you want to do it.
I tell you what, the defense should see
this.
A splendid pass that time by Rowe. First quarter of basketball, just over 2.5 minutes play. And Beverly gets one out of you.
So.
Here's Howard. Offensive struggles continue, missing.
Dobra, no. Masz jutro wolne?
Nie, idę do pracy.
A, bo Michał chciałby do rano. Mówi, że jaki dzień dobry, dobrego
dnia.
Zajebiście.
So Chicago ends up going with the new Michael Beasley. He's checked in for Monty Unis. Brewer comes in for James Harden. And it's Tyrion for Patrick Beverly. Pushing it up. Here's Brooks. Off to a good start as he gets his first shot attempt.
Boy, they've gone on this run and ball movement has been a big
deal.
It really has, Mark. The defense unable to react as quickly as necessary.
Kurwa, to się kurwa, kurwa się.
You know, it wouldn't be a bad idea to put an extra body on him, get some help. Barrels his way in close. He's such a good finisher, he needs more than one guy to defend him.
Now, here's Moore.
And very little fight put up by the defense as he made his way to the bucket.
They did seem to take a cautious approach, Greg, when it came to defending that one. You're right.
Audio, it's not audio,
caution now. I mean, they've got to be aggressive and take some risks to see if they can cut that lead down.
No, chyba. Chyba, żeby to sprawdzać.
Bulls lead by
seven. Nie. Szkoda.
And now the second quarter just getting set to start. And look at how the hustle game has been going for Chicago.
It looks like they're ready to run, fellas. I mean, they haven't hesitated at all to get out on the break so far.
And also, they're jumping on a lot of turnovers, making sure they turn them into points at the other end.
Which is good, though.
And a
chance here presented by Gatorade to see who's on the floor. All fueled up and
to ready
ten,
to go James for the second quarter.
Taking a look at the Rockets. Beverly and Harden, they're the backcourt. McDaniels is out there with Beasley. And it's Capella in the center position. The Bulls making a switch here. Dunleavy's checked in. Gasol penetrating. Excellent D there from Beasley. So many people overlooked Pau Gasol prior to last season, seemed to think that Clark, he was past his prime.
Well, he was a starter in the All-Star game and a huge reason the Bulls played as well as they did. It was a big season for him. A lot of GMs shaking their head for not going harder after.
Shake.
And there's the slam dunk to finish it off.
And what a beautiful way to polish off that sequence. Just strong and attacking the rim.
That just puts a little more momentum on their side, don't you think?
Absolutely.
The defense got to tighten up now. I mean, you can't have the opposing point guard throwing down on you like that.
That's
an intentional foul.
You know, and with Pau Gasol, it was weird to think that the Lakers were just so ready to let him go and move on.
The Rockets making a switch here. Giannis has checked in. It's Harden with the drive. Down it goes for his third basket in as many tries.
Yeah, they've raised their shooting percentage in this quarter, and they're starting to get on track.
And they're starting to heat up is what they're doing. They're on fire. I mean, that's what they need to climb back into this game.
And with the skill set that Powell has and the year he had, there's no telling how long he can play at a high level. Again, one of those guys that never been reliant on the athletic ability to have an impact.
And so it looks like the Rockets will retain possession here. Chicago making some changes. Gibson comes in for Pau Gasol. And Justin Holiday is subbed in for Mike Dunleavy. Stolen by Holiday. And slam dunk by Butler.
And that's the classic 1-2 punch right there. I mean, nice steal. And then how about the elevation, Kevin, on the finish?
And Greg, nothing spurs some quick offense like a great play defensively.
That indicates the importance of great on-the-ball defense, as was displayed right there.
And so here is Houston. The Bulls getting the bucket. And it's Capella missing.
They've done their part here to run down a lot of missed shots. A solid rebounding effort.
Yeah, energy has been the difference, and they're fighting for every loose ball and giving as good as they get on the inside.
And it will go, and the Bulls' lead is cut to just 5 on the basket for Beverly. Bulls have gone 50% from the floor in the second quarter, 3 of 6.
And the Rockets have lost out on some free agent wars the past few years. They have remained competitive, but you wonder what could have been if they landed or kept some of those big names.
So Chicago going with an almost entirely new group here. Joakim Noah is checked in for Gibson. Miritich comes in for Portis. McDermott's checked in for Butler. And Brooks subbed in for Derrick Rose. Houston with a big group substitution here. Howard's checked in for Capella. Giza comes in for McDaniels. Brewer is checked in for James Harden. And it's Terry in for Patrick Beverly. Rockets trailed by 5. Here's Terry. Banked in off the glass. 59 seconds left to play here in the half. Brooks kicks to Miritich. Out to the right wing. This one for 3. McDermott. Offensive rebound. And another shot. And Noah with the nice bucket inside. Noah's got 4 points now in the quarter.
The number of points they've scored in the paint already today is pretty eye-opening.
It really is, Clark. The defenders need to do a better job of closing those lanes to the hoop.
7-second difference, shot and game clock. And Brooks gets it to go.
The assist totals, Kevin, just continue to grow. They're way ahead in that category. Ball movement has been flawless.
Clearly just an example of a different mindset between these teams.
Yeah, just a solid inside.
They're working the glass, really battling in that area of the game, and that's helped them stake this lead.
Terry gets to a reason. Here's Bonayunas. No good on that last second attempt there. And we've reached halftime in this one. Second half just about to get going here. You look at Jimmy Butler, he's really been playing well.
And the defense was soft in that first half, and he took advantage every chance he could, and boy, was he throwing it down hard.
Yes, sir. He has had too many uncontested runs to the hoop, but even if the defender's gotten there, it's been posterized time.
All
right, the second half beginning in just a moment. You look at Jimmy Butler, he's really been playing well.
I know we've said this many times before, but what a great first half. Just an offensive juggernaut.
And, you know, in the end, I wouldn't be surprised if we're talking about what a great second half he had, guys. He can usually keep it going for all four quarters.
All obsession.
Mirotic is out there with Tony Snell. Then it's Brooks. Then it's McDermott. And it's Holiday in the two-guard spot. So that's the five of the game for Chicago. They're going to turn it over.
Dobra, dajcie kilka.
And the official signaled the backcourt violation. Not very careful there. As the Bulls defense was as stout as ever last season, a big part of that is they have guys that challenge you inside and at the rim. Even off the bench, all of their bigs are mobile and protect the basket.
And they continue to control the glass.
Guys, I think they've simply been the more physical team, and that's why they're ahead.
Timely passing leads to assists, and that's been the recipe for success.
Everybody on the same page, completely in sync, tremendous communication and awareness.
Talking about the Bulls and their rim protection, they had the lowest opponent field goal percentage on shots right at the rim.
Yeah, and it helps when you compare seven-footers down low. It's not just the bigs, though. Even the perimeter players track back and challenge at the rim. Really a total team effort.
Offensively, he can be the engine that drives them at any given time.
Can have a basketball just over a minute played so far. Stolen by Harden. Stolen by Holiday. Brooks kicks to Snell. Here's Harden. That's good. Denzel Howard with the assist. And that's now 10 points for James Harden.
And now that's how you start a fast break and how you finish.
Three-pointers, Snell, and that one's good.
That makes three in a row to start the second half.
It's Harden with the drive. Soft touch off the glass. Harden's got six here in this quarter.
And he's having quite the quarter, converting at a really high percentage.
Houston making a switch. Capella's checked in. Here's Gasol. And it's Rose penetrating. And Capella sends it back. Out of bounds, Bulls ball.
Ale mi piłkę zabrałeś. O ty kurwy.
And now around 2 minutes gone by in this half. No good from Gibson.
Yeah, real nice shot selection there. I guess he's working on his buzzer beater form.
That's a reach, but perhaps that is the case. Or maybe he was trying to knock a bird off of the scoreboard.
He's about right, because I still can't figure that one out.
No, I see no birds up.
No.
And it's Howard finishing it off.
Yeah, he went for a little extra on that one.
Well, he usually doesn't finish soft, obviously. You know, he can when necessary, sure, but not that soft.
Not when you can throw it down like that.
Yes, sir.
And I like the fact that the defense is looking to protect the rim at all costs.
Definitely saved a layup with that foul, and he'll make him earn them from the line, and that's what you want to see.
For the Rockets, Mantas is checked in for Howard. Reza comes in for Michael Beasley. And it's Tyrion for Patrick Beverley. Derrick Rose has certainly piled up the awards for such a young player, starting with Rookie of the Year, 111 first place votes to only 5 for the runner-up. We know about his MVP, and that just shines out so brightly.
And how about he and Michael Jordan, the only MVPs in Chicago Bulls history?
Grown man's power flush with the long hang on the rim at the end of it.
Clark, that could be a catalyst for him.
I think you're right.
And we've seen those kinds of plays get them fired up in the past.
Can't cash in from close range.
And typically he has the touch to finish when he's in tight, but not sure on that possession.
You know, looking back to Rose's MVP award, his stats were on another planet that year. He was only the third player to record 2,000 points and 600 assists in a single season since 1973. The other two, LeBron James and Michael Jordan.
Joe is checked in for the Bulls. And a change for the Rockets. Brewers check in. KJ McDaniels, he's checked in for James Harden. 43 seconds left in the third quarter of the game. Gibson for three.
Oh, they recover.
Noah kicks the butt. A three-pointer, no good. Some nice ball movement by the Bulls. No problem knocking that one down. Dunleavy's got 5 points so far.
What are they thinking, leaving him with all that space out there? Do they not know? Have they not heard that this guy is unbelievable? That's a layup for him.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. 5 buckets in a row from the paint.
And on the flip side, Greg, the defenders have to show more fight on the interior. They've got to offer more resistance here.
And Noah with the slam.
I like the fact that he led his teammate right to the ideal spot. You don't always throw it to your teammate. You throw it to where he needs to be. Now that's finishing your work right there.
Powerful two-hand, Jim. You're right.
And I tell you what, if he's got a few more of those in him, this lead will start shrinking even further.
And that's it for the third. We welcome you back to what's been a hard-fought battle. Fourth quarter should be good. The Bulls leading by 6. Fourth quarter on the court for the Rockets. They've got McDaniels. Mantas up there with Trevor Ariza. Then there's Brewer. And it's Beverley in at the point.
And how about the move he made there to come up and get himself clear in the lane for the deuce?
Miracic
with it.
And
Trevor Ariza is going to pick up a foul here. That's his first foul. Pau Gasol's checked in for Noah.
Pau Gasol.
A bucket, number 5 on a 5-for-11 night.
And you like to see since the half now, he's finally starting to come around.
Here's McDaniels, sinks that one from the post.
Seems to me as though they've kicked it into another gear here. I love the way they're moving the ball around now. Everybody's touching it, and everybody's ready to pass and catch and shoot.
And Moore kicks to Rose. Gets the 3-pointer to fall. Rose has got the lead up to 11 now for Chicago.
You know, he was a non-factor in that first half, but now he's making up for lost time.
Now a timeout called by Houston. You gotta like what Derrick Rose has done in this game.
He's definitely rolling offensively. You might not be able to stop him, but you've got to find a way to continue.
Update now from Doris Burke, who's across the way on the sideline.
Hey, Kevin. Well, the Rockets coach had some advice for the team over that last break. He said, listen, fellas, I know you're tired, but we can't coast. We've got to go harder. The win's in sight. We've got to power through it and go get it. Guys, pretty inspirational stuff.
So at Chicago now. The feed to McDermott. This is it to Snell. Stolen by Beverly. Oh, and a fast break for the Rockets. Harden dishes to Mantas. Fast break. Here comes Chicago. Here's McDermott. A shot's good on the assist by Butler. 8 points for Doug McDermott. And a breakdown here, guys. The hustle stats for Chicago.
Boy, their hounding, harassing effort at the defensive end, very impressive. And they forced quite a few turnovers as a result.
Yeah, but they've also done a great job of playing in space, hitting out in transition every opportunity.
And we're about 2 minutes into the fourth quarter now. From seven, and the bucket is good from Butler in deep. And the Bulls lead by 13.
And that's sort of been the story here today, hasn't it?
Harden, that's good.
You know, if you're only looking at the way he's played offensively, you'd think his team would have the lead. You know what? I think he thinks he can make a few improvements to how things are going on right now.
Yeah, and you know, coaches always are looking for ways to tweak things and change it up a little bit, no matter what the situation is. That's what coaches do.
Chicago calls timeout. They lead by 11. A minute 50 left in the fourth. Butler against Harden. Stolen by Harden. The baseline J. Can't hit. And it's Chicago the other way.
And that's been the story of the game. I mean, the rebounding has been very one-sided.
You've been on the winning end. I mean, effort is one thing you can always control in addition to attitude. I would credit this lead to force of will.
Bulls made the postseason for the 10th time in their last 11 seasons last year. They have become a fixture, Greg, in the playoffs in the East.
And how about last season, Kevin, had that interdivision matchup in their first round? Up-and-coming Bucks. Some pickups for them in that series, but they were able to prevail.
31 left in the fourth quarter.
Boy, in that playoff series against the Bucks, the Bulls looked like they were primed for an upset as they started slow, eventually pulled it together and came in as the underdogs against the Cavs.
And the Cavs knocked out the Bulls in six games. Bulls went up 2-1 in the series, but didn't have an answer for LeBron. Strong effort from the Bulls, though, but they just couldn't match the firepower of the Cavs.
Mike Dunleavy, who's checked in for Chicago. Rose comes in for Tony Snell. Kept alive.
You know what? His finishing ability, not really at the level that you would expect from a pro, but he's going to have to start playing with more force. And clearly, we will not be witnessing a spirited comeback tonight, albeit as exciting as that would be. This was an excellent all-around performance for the Bulls.
Two great rebounding teams, Clark.
Yeah, and these guys just worked a little bit harder tonight. That was the edge that was needed.
And what a huge standout performance it was for Derrick Rose. Every time there was a big possession or a big play, He was a major contributor. Just a great all-around game. And guys, you know, we've talked about it before, but it bears repeating. Dwight Howard may be the best overall rebounder in the last decade. Five times out of the last 8 years, he's led the league in rebounding. That's almost impossible to do in the modern NBA.
It's stolen by Dunleavy.
Ja wciskasz B, to robisz zasłonę, ale jak ty widzisz, ja winę, żebyś wyszedł dla mnie. No a tak to zwalę, zasady. Wiem, że to dziwi, wiesz?
And Clark, they've been a little too casual with the ball out there.
Yeah, I think so. Too cool. I mean, just not forceful enough, not alert or aggressive enough, and sometimes trying to do too much with the basketball.
Yeah, but you can't force that square peg into the round hole. Oftentimes, you just got to make that first simple pass and get a rhythm from that.
That free throw, no good. And he sinks the second. 17 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. The clock now can just run out for the Bulls. Nice shot by Portis.
The fans are just loving what's going on here tonight. A really good win for the home team.
It sure is. I mean, they kept this crowd in the game, gave them plenty to cheer about, and really used that home court advantage to their advantage.
They clearly look like a different team now. Suddenly, they've got some energy out on the floor.
Yeah, but it's come a little too late to have a real impact on the game, though. We call this box score window dressing. All it's going to do is make the numbers look a little better than it was.
And so Chicago takes this one, and by a big margin. A confident win, and one where they clearly showed the greater effort.
They certainly put on a good show here at home, and I think they felt they had the edge and that extra little bit of confidence.
And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Clark Kellogg, Greg Anthony, and Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan, along with our entire 2K sports crew, thanking you for tuning in. We'll see you next time.
Co?